Today, I want to show you how you can combine several sheets of data in Microsoft Excel into one sheet using one function. If you want to follow along with today's tutorial, I'll put a link to this data down below in the description. Then you can click on the link, download the workbook, and follow along with me step by step. The goal here today is to create a new sheet that will take all the information from these four sheets into one. And we want to make sure it's dynamic. So I'm going to give you some tips and tricks along the way. The first thing I'm going to do is create a new sheet. So I'm just going to click new sheet here, and we're going to call this total sales. Better spell that correctly, total sales. Now, this is where I'm going to combine all the data from these four different sheets. Notice at the cross of all these tops, that it's all the same. So what I can do here is if I go ahead and select these headers and I go Control C for copy, go over here and Control V, I can paste it in. I'm gonna zoom up on this so it's easier to see. Now, the next thing I can do is if I wanted to just make sure it fit, I'll just select all and just make all the columns fit there. Now, this is where I'm gonna place my formula in here, and we're gonna be using the function VSTACK. So let's go ahead and I'm just gonna click in here, put my equal sign in and start typing VSTACK. This is it, VSTACK, vertically stacks arrays into one array. Just to let you know, this is available in with a Microsoft 365 subscription. If you don't have that, let me post a different video up above in the card that will show you a way that you can combine different sheets and workbooks into one. And it's a simple method as well. Now I'm gonna choose VSTACK. And all I have to do is choose my arrays, and they're on each of these different sheets. So if I go over to North and click in A2 here, I'm gonna give you a shortcut, Control Shift, hit the right arrow, then it stretches, goes automatically where the data ends to the right, and Control Shift down arrow, and it will go to the bottom and stop in that selected area. If I go up where the formula is being created and just put a comma, now I can move on to South Sales and do the same thing. Click an A2, Control Shift right, Control Shift down, add my comma again, go over to West Sales, click an A2 and do the Control Shift right, Control Shift down, comma, and we'll go to our last one, doing the same thing, clicking the same cell and Control Shift right and down. All I need to do now is end with my bracket, hit enter. So we have, if I go down to the very bottom, you should see that we actually have 80 entries because the header is being counted in the first row. And each of these here have 20 in them. So all of those different, the 20 different from each sheet get put into the total sales. And I can still format this. So if I click in here, and if I want to do Control Shift down, add my dollar sign, we can go through and format this. The formula is placed in A2. Here it is across the top. And I just want to point out, notice, so the range is A2 to F21. So if all of a sudden something gets entered in any of these, so if I go to this one and we'll just go ahead and we'll copy two of these. So I'm just going to go Control C and Control V. Now, does this go up anymore? Is it dynamically adding them? Well, no, because those ones are out of range. Let me show you in this next method how we can adapt for additions to this and how we can add another function to help make sure we keep it clean if you get any zeros in there as well. I went to made another sheet called Total Sales 2. I want to show you how you can use the VSTACK function faster. Let's go back to A2, hit equals, and we'll go back to our VSTACK function. This time, rather than going sheet by sheet, if I select North Sales first, hold down Shift and then click East Sales. Notice that they're all highlighted. And then take a look in the formula. It's North Sales colon East Sales, so it's going to be anything in between. You could use the Control key to select certain sheets if they weren't all in a row like that. Now, the next thing I can do is just what I did before. If I click on A2, use my Control Shift right and Control Shift down, now I have that all selected. So I can go ahead and close this and all my information is placed back in here. So now the problem is it doesn't add, if I go ahead and try to add more to each of these, it's not gonna reflect on this total sales. What I need to do, if I look at eSales, let's say, notice it just goes to F21 at the end. So it's just gonna do the 21st row. I need to say, you know what? I know I need at least, let's say 40 rows. I can change this in the formula. So if I go back to this spot, it's A2 to F21. If I go and just click in the formula bar here and change 21 to 40, now it's going to search to those and I could add more in it. The issue is though, look at this. We have some zeros that appear because right now I don't have anything in those rows, so they get brought back as zero. I can add another function to keep this clean, and it's the filter function. If I go up to my formula here and make sure you're in the right spot, so I'm in A2 and click in here and just start typing filter, I'm going to add the filter function. What I need to do is do another VSTACK with the filter function, and I'm going to look up a specific row. So I'm going to select this right up here, select the same thing, Control C. I'll put a comma and Control V. But I don't want it to be searching A2 to F40. I just want it to look in the one column, which is going to be A. So instead of F here, I'm just going to put the A here. Now I wanted to look up, and if there's nothing in there, I just want it to be not returned, return blank. So I'm going to say doesn't equal and return blank, just like this. And I'm going to go and close the bracket up again. I need a double bracket, hit enter. Now if I take a look at this, we can go scroll down and all those zeros are gone. And I have 83 here. Now if I go, let's do a little test on this. I'm going to go and take these rows from this one here. So I'll just go and select a bunch and I'm going to go Control C. And so I've just added more here, Control V. If I go back to total sales now, notice that it just grew by that 4 that I put in here. Now, the other nice thing is I could just bring a whole new sheet in here as well. I've just opened up a different one here and notice I have central sales. I'm going to take central sales here and drag it in between on the one where I was working with. So in between the north and east, I'll drop it here. So now that it's part of the range, because remember we went from north to east, if I look at total sales, it just got all those entries in there as well. The reason why you're seeing this formatted with these numbers is because that is a date format. I can change this if I was going to go control shift down. And if you look at the different types of dates, if I was doing short date, I can change it. So that's just a formatting thing, just like the dollar. But that's how you can use VSTACK to combine multiple sheets and then using filter to even make it more powerful and cleaner. How to combine sheets in Microsoft Excel is a very common question, and I hoped you like learning about VSTACK to take care of this problem. Take a look at that other video that I mentioned about how to combine sheets and even workbooks in Microsoft Excel, and that's using Power Query, and I'll put the link up above in the card and down below in the description. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.